I know I'm late to this party, but because the ending of the show behind her eyes was as wild as everyone said it was, I decided to read the source material. I read the book. As usual, timestamps are in the description. So this book is set up a lot like the show. Three alternating chapters, one from Louise's point of view, one from Adele's, and then we get to see Adele's earlier years with David and her time at the rehab clinic with Rob. Just to make things easier, I'm going to call present day Adele, so Rob and Adele's body, Rob-Adele. And then when he's in Louise's body, I'm going to have to call him Rob-Louise.
If I could describe the show, I would say that it's a mix between A Simple Favor and a cheap version of Gone Girl. It's pretty bad, but I pretty much loved every second of it.
So everything's basically the same in the beginning. Lou and David meet at a bar, they hit it off, they kiss. He runs off. They find out that he's her new boss. She hides in the toilet. She freaks out. They try to end things so that it doesn't go any further than that kiss at the bar. But to be honest, I don't think they try very hard. And in any case, I guess the chemistry is so scorching, they end up sleeping together. On the show, we see David showering at Lou's place and he goes creeping back home. And Rob-Adele is pretending to sleep. In the book, Rob-Adele tells us that she knows that David and Louise have slept together. In fact, she's known about the two of them since their meeting in the bar. Rob-Adele also tells us that when David showers at Lou's apartment, he uses a travel-sized version of his own shower gel that he carries in his pocket. So at this point, we know that Rob-Adele somehow knows everything, but we just don't know how. I feel like Lou's character in the book is kind of weirder in her obsession with Adele. In the show, you see that she's drawn to David and Rob-Adele, and she's preoccupied with her weird love for them, and it was annoying. But you also just want her to get the hell out of the situation because you kind of root for her, even though she's the worst. In the book, she's obsessed in a way that's, to me anyway, more disturbing and concerning. Book Louise is quite a bit more irritating as well, but I suppose we get to read all of her thoughts, so it just gets a bit much when she obsesses. In the book, Louise describes herself as a dumpy, scruffy blonde, although I can only imagine her as the Louise that we saw in the show. So in typical Louise fashion, when Rob-Adele gives her this really exclusive membership to the gym and kind of influences Louise into being a bit more healthy, Louise kind of gets a little bit obsessed and she's counting calories, all because, as she says at one point in the book, like she doesn't want to let down Rob-Adele. And Louise being so eager to please Rob-Adele is actually what makes her so easy to exploit and manipulate. Basically just like on the show. In the book, she's also a lot meaner to Sophie, I feel, and there's a clear frenemy vibe there on Lou's part. Lou feels as though she needs to beg Sophie to be in her life, but unlike Sophie, Rob-Adele has all the time in the world for her, so she pretty much pushes Sophie to the side, which is what she does on the show as well. Lou gets really defensive and kind of passive-aggressive when Sophie, being all of us, tries to warn her. So on the show, Louise is shown as drinking a lot. She likes to drink wine at home, and in the book, it's kind of worse, mostly because she's often thinking about the wine as well, and she's talking about her hangover or something, or she's just drinking. This isn't a judgment, it's more just an observation. It really stands out, and I just kind of found myself feeling a bit sorry for and concerned, you know, for this fictional character. Otherwise though, she's not the most sympathetic character, mostly because of the way that she treats Sophie. And then there's her insistence that she keeps both Rob-Adele and David. She's pretty territorial and rather entitled. I really enjoyed the moments between her and Adam though. They're really sweet together. She is a good mother, but it's also kind of sad that she feels that Adam is all she has. At the same time though, her loneliness and some of her desperation is kind of relatable. So a bit about Adele. She grew up as a wealthy girl who lived on an estate, and she was an only child to parents who kind of underparented her, and she kind of follows David around. He's the farmer's son and a neighbor, and he works nearby. Adele's 8 at the time. David is 5 years older. It's nothing weird. It's just kind of like a childhood friendship. Anyway, it's during these years that eventually that Adele tells David about her dreams. And he gives Adele a book on dreams. He says it's some kind of new agey thing, but it's from this book that Adele learns about lucid dreaming, and she does the whole controlling her dreams thing. She does try to explain this to David, but he doesn't really believe it, and we learn later on that he just thought that this was part of her mental illness. We see both in the book and on the show that this is how Rob and Adele bond. Okay, so a bit about Rob-Adele. David calls Rob-Adele a sociopath, but I mean, I listen to a lot of true crime podcasts, and my diagnosis is that he's a narcissistic psychopath, right? David obviously doesn't know what we know, but Rob-Adele's just too good at manipulation and the careful planning, and he really revels in the attention and the love that he gets from Louise, even though he has some kind of disdain for her. I suppose she's just useful to him. And obviously the fact that David is stuck with him. In the book, they're just as miserable as they are on the show, and Rob-Adele even says at some point, like, he's so sick of it, but he just loves David so much, and he is just desperate to keep him. In the book, they go into detail about Rob-Adele's fragile mental health, which all started in the aftermath of the well incident, when Rob took over Adele's body. Rob tells us, actually, that he faked several breakdowns to keep David closer, and then eventually when that stopped working, he resorted to threats. So he basically reminding David that his watch was down in the well with the body. The incident with Marianne is also a lot worse in the book, because in the book, Marianne's cat doesn't remain unharmed or alive. It's just a warning as well, like that scene is really unsettling to read. Rob-Adele also starts a fire at a florist because of his jealousy. What I found interesting was that Rob tells us in the book that David's watch falling into the well was actually just a happy accident. He didn't mean to implicate David, but it was convenient that it happened because he got to use that as leverage. Anyway, the friendship between Rob and Adele in their teens is pretty much the same. But, you know, as we know, Rob is pretty obsessed with her and he hates David. And he thinks that David is going to come between him and Adele. So the second last chapter of the book is from Rob-Louise's perspective, after the fire. So he's looking at Louise's grave. Obviously, only he knows that this is Louise in Adele's body. To everybody else, Adele is dead. And thinking about how he fell in love with David, we saw those weird looks at first and thought that it was because he hated David for stealing Adele away. But for Rob, in fact, he said the stars aligned, he fell in love, and he felt that Adele would just be keeping David back. It was fate, and he shouldn't be with weak, simpering Adele. And that's when he first got the idea. So he began to basically single white female Adele. We know from David that Rob was kind of weird, and that one evening they stayed up late and Rob was asking a lot of questions about his relationship with Adele. And even though David was kind of gracious, he hoped that their friendship would end. We also know from David that Rob-Adele wanted the abortion and that she spent a lot of money. And while he didn't actually care about the money itself, he was scared that she was being very reckless with it, and so they agreed that David take control of the finances. From Rob's perspective, he's never really had any money. He's suddenly in this new social class, so he goes overboard. Rob-Louise is thinking back and telling us how glorious he felt in Adele's body, and he refers to his body in the well as a pasty shell. He also acknowledges that he should have shown more remorse over Rob's death. He also explains the abortion by saying that, you know, he was already dealing with being in a woman's body, but also it was Adele's baby and not his, and he wanted no part of Adele in this new life of his. So anyway, in the end, David goes to confess, but he's let go after the note from Rob-Adele is found in the apartment. And since there are no other fingerprints and Rob-Adele has confessed to everything and Adele's body is now dead, that's all tied up perfectly and they're finally free, which actually poor David, because he's not. So the honeymoon scene is pretty much the same in the book. We got one of the greatest moments in the whole show where Adam kind of outs Rob-Louise for kind of lying about being into boats. And we get that look from Rob-Louise. And when I watched the show, I was a little bit hopeful that perhaps Adam would grow up and, you know, finally crack the case. But in the book, Rob-Louise is already on it. He says that he knows that Adam knows that there's something wrong, but he just doesn't know what. And he says, Rob-Louise, that he'll need to sever the links with Ian and Adam because they know Louise so well. And he says as well, like, it shouldn't be too difficult to arrange because children are notoriously accident prone and grief can bring people together, referring to him and David. So basically, to wrap up, I think that Netflix does a really good job of staying faithful to the book, but they made a good call to pretty much cut out some parts that weren't vital to the story or the parts that were too gruesome. So there's no real reason to read the book. So the book ends where the show ends and the story's over, but the show has been pretty viral, so who knows? Netflix might get creative and give us a second season. I'd love to be a fly on the wall to see how this marriage starts out and how it eventually changes over time and whether David picks up on any of it. Anyway, that's it for this video. If you've enjoyed this, please feel free to like and subscribe, and thank you for watching.